Okay, here we have a gas phase reaction in a membrane type flow reactor where one of the products can diffuse out of the membrane. So there are several effects that we can observe when we decrease the catalyst pellet size inside that membrane reactor. Our overall observation is that the conversion drops from 75 to 50%, and we want to describe at least two factors that could explain the decreased conversion. Depending on what you assume in this problem, it can actually be you can have multiple reasonable answers. We'll describe at least three factors that could explain the decreased conversion. All of them are related, however, to the fact that when you decrease the particle diameter, what you expect mainly to happen is that through the Ergen equation, that the pressure drop will go up, and therefore that the pressure, say, at the outlet of the reactor and throughout the reactor, except for right at the inlet, will go down. And so if we're operating now at lower pressure, that can have a number of consequences. Okay, again, this can be seen through this fact that we have a larger pressure drop, can be seen through the Ergen equation, the dependence on the particle diameter within that equation. Or you can just reason out that, larger catalyst particles, say a tube filled with basketballs, it's easier to have flow going through that tube than a tube filled with sand. Right in here, of course, the diameter difference isn't so large, just 5 millimeters to 1 millimeter, but that's the general trend. Let's talk about some effects that this decreased pressure in the reactor will have. For one thing, we normally expect that the forward reaction rate is going to be proportional in some way to the pressure of the reactants. All right, the pressure of A to the alpha and the pressure of B to the beta power. And so if we're decreasing the total pressure, we're therefore going to also decrease the partial pressure of those reactants, and that will decrease the forward rate so that we might get a lower conversion. Another factor that could be important in this increased pressure drop is that the reactants have more total moles than the products. And so the equilibrium conversion will go down as pressure goes down. Or another way of saying that is that the rate of the reverse reaction is not going to go down as quickly as the rate of the forward reaction as pressure drops. So that's going to tend to decrease our equilibrium conversion as a result of pressure drop, and our overall conversion as a result of pressure drop. Finally, of course, this is a membrane reactor, and the flux, which I'll write as a capital R, the diffusive flux of component C out of the membrane, will be equal to some pseudo mass transfer coefficient times a cross-sectional area, an area that's cross-sectional to the diffusion, times a driving force for diffusion, which will be the pressure in C of C in the reactor. All right, minus potentially zero if we have no C outside the reactor or very little, or pressure of C on the outside of the membrane, the permeate side. And so here, by decreasing the total pressure, all right, we're going to ultimately affect this pressure PC and decrease it. And that will lower the rate of diffusion of C out of the membrane, which again will push the reaction more to the left by Le Chatelier's principle. And so we see at least these three factors that could be responsible for the lower conversion.